Finally tonight, a look back at the unusual 40-year career of a Los Angeles artist. NewsHour correspondent Spencer Michels has the story.
Inspiration is where you find it, even in the parking lot of an abandoned industrial site. In the California desert, the detritus of civilization litters the landscape, inspiring this assemblage called Aristotle's Cage, one of 69 works in a new show by Los Angeles artist Michael McMillen. He has found inspiration in an intriguing collection of everyday things and places, even in seedy motels that reek of decay and intrigue. Intrigue he has enhanced with tricks and trivia. Red Trailer Motel is perhaps the showpiece of the first ever retrospective of McMillen's art, now at the Oakland Museum of California, a museum specializing in the history and art of the Golden State. McMillen, now 65, got training as an engineer before switching to art, and he's used his mechanical skills to shape his installations. He uses material and memories accumulated over the years.
We're outside the Red Trailer Motel in, you name it, wherever. It's basically an installation that hopefully takes the viewer, the museum visitor, out of where they think they are and puts them into another realm in time and place.
I see a sign, see the UFO landing site.
That's
pretty funny.
I think so.
But in a way, the motel is pretty tragic. I mean, this is not a place you'd want to stay.
No, you probably wouldn't want to. You didn't have to. It has tinges of maybe the Bates Motel. I wanted to create something that would really, like you said, address the dark side and the humorous side simultaneously.
McMillen fits into a new school of artists, says Phil Linares, the chief curator at the museum.
Nowadays, artists are creating installations, things that are experiential, things that people can walk through and experience. And McMillen is one of the people who is really pushing that particular idea.
This is one of McMillen's newest works. It's called Lighthouse. There is nothing pretentious about what he does, but that's not to say that it's unsophisticated or simple.
While Lighthouse has a slightly sinister, mysterious look, McMillen wants it to be familiar enough to draw in visitors who can search for clues, even in the sounds, to give it meaning and context. A child of Hollywood, McMillen is steeped in the movies, and they permeate much of his work.
When I got out of art school, I found employment working, building sets and doing miniatures for films. And that was a great kind of postgraduate education.
The McMillen exhibit is not confined to one room or even several like most one-man shows. Rather, it's scattered throughout the Oakland Museum's collection.
I mean, sometimes when I sit in the Pavilion of Rain, I imagine I'm in Port Arthur, Texas, in a rainstorm.
I built that in 1987, a year after my father had passed away. And I did it as an homage to him.
Pavilion of Rain is an old shack on a lake, found objects stuck together, sitting in a pool of water that collects and amplifies the rain that falls from the ceiling, an inner sanctum.
So once you're in that piece, it has an amazing calming effect, at least on me.
McMillen often uses water.
I was walking with my dog through an alley, and I found this single old gymnasium locker.
And he added a small water pump you can't see.
The sound of water running implies time change. You see a lot of water symbols in my work, which, again, like the wheel, is kind of a thought about process, endless process of water and time, erosion, change.
Michael McMillen says he expects those who see his installations to work a bit, to interpret what they find, and they'll find plenty of mysteries. His retrospective, including some films he made, runs at the Oakland Museum in Oakland, California, through August 14th.